Hello everyone. Today we will do our session 2 on mathematical logic. We'll start with the first exercise 1.1. Okay, it's a simple exercise. I hope we remember what we did in the first session. What are statements, truth tables for conjunctions, disjunctions, conditional, biconditional statements and negation. Okay, so let us begin with exercise 1.1. Now, the first question says, verify whether these are statements or no. And if they are, then tell their truth values. Okay, so which is the first statement that we have over here? We have 5 + 4 = 13. Now, this is a statement. So we'll write, yes, it is a statement. And what is its truth value? 5 + 4 = 9. It's not 13. So truth value is false. Okay, the next one is x - 3 = 14. Okay, so is x - 3 = 14 a statement? Very important. Now, if we go to solve this, we will get x value as 17. Okay, so only when x is 17, this statement stands true and otherwise it stands false. So that means it has two truth values, which is not possible for a statement. It should either be true or be false. So we call this that it is not a statement. Okay. Then next one. Let's go to the next one. The next one says, close the door. Third one is a request. So it is not a statement. So we just write because it's a order. So not a statement. Okay. Next one. Fourth one is 0 is a complex number. Yes, 0 is a complex number. So we write 0 is a complex number, is a statement, first of all. So, yes, it is a statement. And what is its truth value? Its truth value is T. Okay, next one. Please get me breakfast. Please, that means it's a request, so it does not fall under statement. So we just write, no, it's not a statement. Then five, then sixth one. Congruent triangles are similar. So yes, first of all, it is a statement. Yes, it is a statement. Okay. And what is the truth value of it? Congruent triangles, yes, they are obviously similar. So we call them truth value as true. Okay. Next one. Is x square equal to x. Now x square equal to x, okay, this will be true for some numbers and false for some numbers. Let's check how. If I say 1, x is equal to 1. If x is equal to 1, then x square will be 1 square equal to 1, which is true. Okay, let's take x equal to 2. When x is equal to 2, we'll get 2 square, that is 4. It is not equal to x, right? So that means it has both values, true and false. So this does not fall under statements because a statement cannot have two values at the same time. Okay, so we'll call this as not as a statement. So I'm just writing no over here. Okay, not a statement. Let's go to the next one. The next one says a quadratic equation cannot have more than two roots. We know this, that a quadratic equation means it has two roots. Okay, so it cannot have more than two roots. So first of all, yes, it is a statement. And secondly, its truth value is true. Okay, the next one, ninth one is do you like mathematics? Now, this is an opinionated question. I might like it, you may not like it, or vice versa. So, do you like mathematics? We'll write, no, it is not a statement. It can have various truth values. Okay, then the 10th one. The sun sets in the west. That is true. It sets in the west. And yes, it is a statement. So, yes, it is a statement. And the truth value is T. Okay. One second. Sorry. 11th one. What does the 11th one say? All real numbers are whole numbers. All real numbers are whole numbers. Is it true? First of all, is it a statement? Yes, it is a statement. And what is its truth value? Are all real numbers whole numbers? Can we say that? No, because real numbers include fractions, okay, decimals, which are not whole numbers. So the truth value of this statement is F. Okay. Next one, this is the 12th one. 12th one says, can you speak in Marathi? Again, it is an opinionated question. Some can, some cannot. It could be true, it could be false. So we say that no, it is not a statement. Okay. Next one, 13. 13 says x square minus 6x minus 7 is equal to 0 when x is equal to 7. X square minus 6x minus 7 is equal to 0 when x is equal to 7. Okay, now they have clearly mentioned the condition when x is 7. So we'll solve this and check if you're getting 0. And if you are getting a 0, then we'll get the truth value as well. First of all, yes, it is a statement. Why? Because it is given clearly with its condition. Then is it true or no is what we have to tell. Okay. So yes, it is a statement. And how do we find the truth value? We substitute 7 in the equation. So 7 square minus 6 into 7 minus 7. That is 49 minus 42 minus 7. That is 7 minus 7. And so answer is 0. So yes, it is a statement and its truth value is. Okay, the next one, the 14th one, the sum of cube roots of unity is 0. The 14th one, sum of cube roots of unity. Now, what does this question mean, first of all? Okay. So, sum of cube roots of unity, what does this mean? First of all, let us say that x cube is equal to 1. We are going to find the three roots of 1. Okay. So, this is the procedure of finding it. X cube minus 1 is equal to 0. Now, since the power is 3, that means it has 3 roots. So, how will we find it? We'll factorize this. X minus 1, x square plus x plus 1. This is the formula for a cube minus b cube. Okay. So from this we say that x minus 1 is equal to 0 or x square plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay. So x is equal to 1 or we'll factorize this. Now first of all, this is not normal factorization. Why? Because 1 cannot be split into something that would give me 1 again. Okay. So that means we are going to use the formula for factorization. B square minus 4ac is equal to 0 and then find the roots. Okay. So the two roots that we get other than x equal to 1 are x is equal to minus 1 minus root 3i upon 2 or x is equal to minus 1 plus root 3i upon 2. Okay. So these are the three roots of 1. Which are they? X is equal to 1. X is equal to this or x is equal to minus 1 plus root 3i upon 2. Now the question says that sum of the cube roots of unity. So this is the first root, second root, third root. We have to add all of them. So 1 plus minus 1 minus root 3i upon 2 plus minus 1 plus root 3i upon 2. Now when you add this together, you are going to get the answer 0. Okay, try and do the addition, you will get the answer 0. And therefore, what is the truth value of the first of all? Yes, it is a statement. And what is its truth value? The truth value is T. Okay, because sum of all the cube roots of unity is 1. Which are the cube roots? 1 minus 1 minus root 3i, it's an imaginary number, upon 2. X is equal to minus 1 plus root 3i upon 2. Okay. So when you add all these three, you get the answer 0. So yes, the sum of cube roots of unity is 0. Okay. The last one, it rains heavily. Again, a question that could change from place to place. It could have a truth value as T or if. So if it has two truth values, then we say that it is not a statement. Okay, so the last one is not a statement. Let's go to question two now. Okay, what does question two say? Write the following compound statement symbolically. Okay, so that means how we used to write for disjunctions, conjunctions. One of the statement is P, the other is Q, and you join them with the symbols. So the first statement, okay, is Nagpur is in Maharashtra. We'll call that part as P of the statement. Nagpur is in Maharashtra. And Chennai is in Tamil Nadu. So and, that means and Chennai is in Tamil Nadu is your second part of the statement. So P and Q. Okay, let's go to the next one. The next one says triangle is equilateral or isosceles. So triangle is equilateral is P part. Okay, or so V, that is the symbol for or, and it is equilateral or isosceles. So isosceles is your second part. Okay, the next one, three. The angle is right angle if and only if it is of measure 90 degrees. So the angle is right angle is your P part. If and only if means biconditional statement. And biconditional, after that, it is of measure 90 degrees is your second part. So P, biconditional, Q. Then the fourth one. Angle is neither acute nor obtuse. Okay, now we have to break this sentence into two different parts. Angle is neither acute. So let me say that the angle is acute is the P sentence. So angle is neither acute. So there is a negation. So we'll say negation P. Okay. And it is neither obtuse. Right. So nor obtuse means it is not this and it is not this. So and I will write. Okay. And it is obtuse is Q, nor we'll put a negation. So always remember if there are negative words in your sentence, that means I have to use negation first thing. Secondly, give P the value of the positive sentence and then make it negation. So my P part is angle is acute. Okay. Angle is neither acute will become negation P. My Q part is angle is obtuse and negation of that will be neither obtuse. And it says that it is neither acute and it is nor obtuse means both are not possible. So both means and. Okay. So negation P and negation Q. Okay, let's go to the fifth one. If triangle ABC is right angled at B, then measure angle A plus measure angle C is 90 degrees. So if and then, so single conditional statement first of all, then triangle ABC is right angled at B becomes my P part. Okay, single implication, and measure angle A plus C is 90 degrees. Okay, so that is single implication. Next one. Hima Das wins gold medal if and only if she runs fast. So if and only if is your double conditional biconditional statement. Hima Das wins a gold medal is your P part, and if she runs fast is your Q part. She runs fast is your Q part. If and only if is your biconditional part. Okay, next one, seventh one. X is not irrational number but is a square of an integer. So X is a rational number, we will X is a irrational number, we will take that as P. Okay, so X is not an irrational number, negation P. Okay, but is a square of an integer, so is a square of an integer is P. And but is a conjunction, and that is why we write and. So negation P and, sorry, just a minute, I made a mistake over here. To call the second part of the sentence as Q, negation P and Q. Okay, I'll just explain the negation part again. So the first part of the sentence is X is not irrational number. Okay, so first we will say, let X be the irrational number, or X is a irrational number, that is P. So if I have to write negation P, it will be negation. X is not a irrational number. Negation P. Okay. And it could be a perfect square. So it could be a perfect square is Q, but is a conjunction, and that is why it is given by AND. Okay. So this is your question 2. Let's go to question 3 now. Question 3 is a little bit of using your truth tables that we did in the first section. Okay. Let's go to the question 3. The question 3 says, write the truth values of the following. Now, what do we understand by write the truth values? See, the question has different statements combined with conjunctions, disjunctions, or implications. Okay. We'll formulate that in P and Q and then find their truth values. We'll start with the first one. The first question says, 4 is odd or 1 is prime. Okay. 4 is odd or 1 is prime. Okay. Now, which is your first part? This is P. 4 is odd and 1 is prime is Q. Okay. So, our symbolic representation will be P or Q. Okay. Now, tell me 4 is odd. Okay. So, 4 is odd. Is this true? Is P sentence true? No, 4 is not an odd number. So, we'll just put an equivalent sign. What is the truth value of P? It is false. It is not. Okay. And or why 1 is prime. Is 1 a prime number? No. It is neither prime nor composite. So again, what is the truth value of Q? It is false. Now, if you go back to your truth tables, what is F or F? Okay. It is F. If you remember the or truth table, in that, if any one of the values is true, then the P or Q remains true. But if both values are false, then false or false is, answer is false. So P or Q becomes false only when both are false. So what is the truth value of our sentence? The truth value of our sentence is F. I'll do the next one so that it becomes clearer. Second one says 64 is a perfect square and 46 is a prime number. 64 is a perfect square. Okay. This is P part. And they have said, okay. So, and 46 is a prime number. So, this is my Q part. Okay. Now, it says P and Q. Let me find out the truth value of P sentence. 64 is a perfect square. Yes, it is a perfect square. So the truth value is T. And symbol remains as it is. Okay. Truth and 46 is a prime number. Is 46 a prime number? No, it has factors. So it is not a prime number. So what is the truth value of the second sentence? It is F. Okay. So what is the answer for T and F? The answer is F. How? If you remember the truth table for conjunctions, that is AND truth table, if both values are true, only then the answer is true. Otherwise, all the answers are false. So T and F answer is false. Okay. Let's go to the third one. The third one is 5 is a prime number and 7 divides 94. 5 is a prime number. So this is my P part. And 7 divides 94 is my Q part. Let us check the conjunction once again. The joining part. It is 5 is a prime number and 7 divides 94. So it's AND. So P and Q. Okay. Now let's check what is the truth value of P. Is 5 a prime number? Yes. AND remains as it is. 7 divides 94. Is it possible? Let's check. So no, it does not divide 94. So this is false. Okay. So what is T and F? It is F. Again, the AND truth table is true only when it is true only when both are true. Okay. Next one. First one. It is not true that 5 minus 3i is a real number. It is not true that 5 minus 3i is a real number. Okay. So let me say that. I said when there is negation, so we will call P as the positive sentence. So what is the positive sentence? It is true that 5 minus 3i is a real number, P. Okay. Now it is not true, so I have to find negation P. First of all, what is the truth value of this sentence? Of P, that is, it is true that 5 minus 3i is a real number. What is the truth value of that sentence? Is it true that 5 minus 3i is a real number? No, because I is just an imaginary number, so truth value of P is F. Okay, and they've asked us to do negation of F. What is negation of F? It is true. So what is truth value of this entire statement? It is T. Okay. Next one. If 3 into 5 is 8, then 3 plus 5 is equal to 15. If 3 into 5 is 8, then 3 plus 5 is equal to 15. Okay, so there is an if and then. That means there is conditional sentence. Okay, so 3 into 5 is 8 is your P part. Okay, and conditional 3 plus 5 is 15 is your Q part. Okay, now what is the truth value of 3 into 5 is equal to 8? No, 3 into 5 is 15, right? So P part is false, conditional. 3 plus 5 is also not 15, so this is also false. So F implies F. What is the truth value for implication of F implies F? It is true. Okay. So how do we remember this? Implication, I told you how to remember. Only when the back is true, but the front is false. That means the first sentence is true, still the second sentence is false. That time your answer to this will become false. Okay. So, but otherwise all the other times it will remain true. Okay. So F implies F is also true. This is your truth table for implication. I told you how to remember it. If the back is true and the front is false, then it is a false statement. Okay. P implies Q becomes false only that time. Let's go to the next one, the sixth one. Milk is white if and only if sky is blue. So milk is white is your P part. And sky is blue is your Q part. They have used if and only if. Okay, so it will be P double implication Q. Okay, P double implication Q. Now milk is white has a truth value as 2. Double implication sky is blue, true. That means double implication of true and true is true. Double implication is easier to remember. Both values are same, then the truth value of that table will remain T. Okay. And if they are different, then it will be false. Let's go to the seventh one. Seventh one says 24 is a composite number or 17 is a prime number. So 24 is a composite number. That is T. And what is the second part? Say 17 is a prime number. 17 is a prime number. This is Q. Okay. P or Q. First of all, what is the truth value of P? 24 is a composite number. Yes, it is. So true. 17 is a prime number. Yes, it is true. So T or T. So what is the answer to this? T. Okay. We finished with three questions of exercise 1.1. We are left with two more questions, which we will do in the next session. If you have any doubts regarding question 1, 2, 3, simplest of simplest doubts, please ask so that there is no confusion as we go ahead. One thing I would like to tell you, please go through the tables of conjunction, disjunction, negation, because we will require them as we do the next questions of this chapter. So we have to be thorough with the tables of conjunction, disjunction, and implication and biconditional implication. Okay, if you have any doubts, again I'm repeating, please let me know so that we can clear that in the beginning of the chapter. Okay, thank you. We'll continue in the next session for exercise 1.1.